Hello there, Michaelers. How is everyone doing today? Of course, I'm running late. I needed to go somewhere and do something, but I get caught up. I got so many things that I got going on. I'm running two businesses, right? Running two businesses, Elbow Grease Productions and the Stays All Day Shea Fragrance Body Butter. And I've got a perfume store, right? Because so far I'm up to 20 fragrances that I have released to you guys. 20 fragrances. Anyway, I wanted to show you guys something. Hello, hello, hello there. So nice to see you guys. I had said that I was going to report on something. I think I'm set up to report on it. But before I do, I want to tell you guys what I found. I want to show you what I found, okay? I found a King of Pop fragrance. Oh my God. I found it. I was at a wholesaler's. And I was going through their fragrances. They say they have 3,000 and they might. And I found King of Pop fragrance. Oh my God. Oh my God. So, of course, I had to buy it. Of course, I had to make a shea butter out of a King of Pop fragrance. So, you guys want to know what I named it? You know how I do them. Gucci Guilty, Bougie Silky, Coco Chanel, Go Go Channel, Juicy Couture, Pussy Mature, Dracar, Darth Rakar, so it's fun. Flowers Blasting is Flower Bomb is Flowers Blasting. Creed is, oh my God, British Weed. So this is what I named it. I think I'm so proud of myself. Sing on Sock for King of Pop. Sing on Sock. Michael Glittery Socks, he sings Sing on Sock. So you guys got to order some. I put it on the website already. So it smells wonderful. Okay, some of these older scents are not as heavy of a scent. So it's a little bit light of a scent, but it still smells magnificent. Okay, so Sing on Sock for King of Pop. Okay, and then I want to know if you guys can guess this one. Did I already tell you this one? This one. Forgot She. Versace. Okay, good girl, goody two shoe. Okay, so I have these all on the website now, so they're on there. Okay, so that you can order it. Plus, Bougie Silky, Go Go Chanel, or Doré Cherry's back. Doré Cherry smells, oh my God, so good. I think that's what. No, I got on King of. I have on Sing on Sock. I have Sing on Sock. That's what I have on it. It smells wonderful. And look at my chest, guys. This is a chest of a woman that will be 60 years old in May. Not bad. Not too many wrinkles. Not too many. But hey, I've been putting it on. I've been putting it on, okay, every day. All right. So I tried to make body wash. Don't worry, I'm getting to some stuff. I tried to make body wash, but perfume and in body wash is not good for the ladies' pum-pum-pum-pum-pum. Okay? It's not good for that. It causes yeast infection. So I decided that I'm not even going to mess with it. I'm not even going to mess with body wash. So I have done hand wash. Hand wash. And it's really good. I use it all the time for my hands. I use it all the time. This is, remember, red is my birthmark. I use it all the time for my hands. And I think my hands look pretty good for 60. If I had fingernails, they would look really pretty. But nowadays with inflation and everything being so expensive, I just can't afford it. Okay, and then all the money that it takes to start a business, and I haven't been on a regular job. But anyway, so I have I'm gonna this is not on the website yet, but I have hand wash, okay? And it's in and it's all natural ingredients, sunflower oil, coconut oil. Shea butter. And what else do I have? This smells so good. I swear to you guys. This one's the Go Go Chanel. It smells so good. Okay, so in the next couple of days, I have it in Go Go Chanel. Flowers Blasting is really, it smells good, but it's light. It's very light, but it smells wonderful. Bougie Silky. Oh my God. Gotta shake it sometimes. I'm gonna put something else in it so you won't have to shake it too much. Bougie Silky, Gucci Guilty. And then this one, oh my God, British Weed, OMG, British Weed. That one's strong. That's male scent. Okay, so if you smoke a lot of weed and you can't be walking around smelling like weed, this is the one for you. Okay. And also Go-Go Channel is good. Okay. So anyway, so go to Stays All Day Shea Fragrance Body Butter. And I have to change all the tags off from saying body wash to hand. Maybe I should just, I don't know, it's a little tacky, huh? Me doing that, I need to take it off, make a new one. Okay, so what else do I have here? Castile soap. It has jojoba and hemp, almond, prickly pear, oils. It has distilled water, organic sunflower oil, vegetable glycerin, shea butter, and then the fragrance oils. Okay, I swear, you guys. This one's masculine, but Go-Go Channel, it smells so good you want to eat it. I swear, but you can't eat it because it's not for eating. Golly, smells so good. So anyway, and I smell great for my sing-on socks and my forgot she. Okay, so that's fun. That's fun. All right, so now we got that out of the way. Remember I told you guys before that I had there were let's see. Let me do this. Let's do this. There was a billboard for Michael Jackson One. Remember I told you down the street? Well, okay, the two big streets in Woodland Hills is Topanga Canyon and Ventura Boulevard, right? Topanga Canyon goes north and south, and Ventura Boulevard goes east and west, right? I think I got that right. And so on those two streets in Woodland Hills, near my house is one Michael Jackson One billboard, and then I saw another Michael Jackson One billboard. You want me to come see Michael Jackson One, Michael? You want me to come see it? Okay, I'm gonna come see it. All right. Okay. I will come. I will go see it. I will go see it. Okay. They're digital boards, and I know I showed you guys it last time, but I'm just gonna show it to you again since I brought it up. Where is it? It's oh, here it is. Okay. So this is the one. I didn't even take a picture of the other one. Okay. There it is. Okay. There it is, the Michael Jackson one. So, you guys, I might be going out to Vegas sometime soon. We drive. Got to wait till it's not so wet because I don't like driving in the rain. Okay. And CFC, so be nice enough, you know. And we're just going to go for a day. We can't spend a lot of money on my hotel, and we can't spend a lot of money while we're there. And I can't gamble, except I'm going to play, I'm going to look for the Michael Jackson slot machine, even though I couldn't find it. All because of Wade and James, you know. You know, because that slot machine was fun. Don't stop till you get enough. It was great. It was great. Dun, 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 dun. Bad, you know, it played all Michael's great hits and it was paid and it was great. All right, so now we got that out of the way. Let's see. Oh, an old clue. We're going to look at another clue. That I kind of brought up, but I kind of didn't bring up. And it was, here it is. Okay. And it was in that video that I told you guys about. And I kind of just went over it real quick. Remember the one with Chamilla? That was Michael. That's why he changed the date to January 15, 2012. Because Michael, he doesn't like to talk. And he's a nonverbal communicator, and he does a lot of clues. And I've been involved in so many of his death hoax clues as Peter Michael Bobby, that I've learned how he thinks. I learned how he communicates. He leaves a lot of clues. So that one video that was uploaded way back the first time, April 21st, 2010, and then was changed to January 15, 2012, and in it had Chamilla. Okay, so he was trying to tell me, I am the Chamilla that called you, and I am Peter Michael Bobby, because of the January 15th was the first time Bobby Anderson, aka Peter Pan, PYT, aka Peter Madani, contacted me, aka Michael Jackson contacted me. So everybody is clear, okay? Michael cannot be himself because Michael faked his death. So therefore, if you're going to do a trick, you got to know how to get out of the trick. Okay? You know how to get in it, you got to know how to get out of it. Michael was trained by the best magicians in the whole wide world. He hung around David Blaine, Uri Geller, even Majestic, which was Joe's friend. He was a magician. Chris Angel, David Copperfield, he out Siegfried and Roy. Michael knows illusions because there's no really such thing as magic. It's all tricks, illusions, diversions, distractions, mirrors, smoke and mirrors. That's what it is. And that's what this death hoax is. Okay. So if you don't know all you need to know about Michael, like I just named just off the top of my head, five top magicians that Michael knows and hung out with. Okay. We got pictures of Michael hanging out with them. Okay. Chris Angel, Paris said Paris hung out with Chris Angel. Okay. And Shauna confirmed with Grace was there. About David Copperfield. Okay. And then there was that musician, that magician that was at This Is It, that was ready the next day to do the disappearing from a bed act. I went over his name. He's Latino name, Latino, Latin name, a Spanish name. And I went over that in a previous video. So that musician, he was going to disappear from a bed the next day. That what was on the schedule for rehearsals. I mean, and the last thing he rehearsed was Earth Song. And you look at the Earth Song video, it's about the dead reversing back to the living, that the dead ain't really dead. Okay? I mean, so many death hoax clues. It's outrageous that I am being ignored like I am. It is outrageous. It is irresponsible for the people who run the media, mainstream media, not to report all this stuff. Plus, when you just look at the death trail, everything is a game. I went over that last week, last live, 14. It's just so much. It's just so much, so much, so much. Okay, watch my live docuseries. Okay, so I'm gonna play some of this video. Remember, it was by MJ Hoax Evidence. And I wonder if Michael had anything to do with this video. Now, of course, like I said, if you get in a trick, you know how to get out of a trick. So if Michael was pretending and using Bobby Anderson as himself, right? Of course he's going to have a front set up. So when it gets too hot that it's really me, then you get up in the front and you go, "No, it's me. It's really, 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 really me. It's not Michael Jackson." Okay? I mean, duh. That's the only way it all makes sense. That's the only way it all makes sense. Because why the hell else is Michael paying freaking property taxes in South Carolina, which is where Bobby Anderson's supposed to be from? Okay, boom. All right. So anyway, so here is so here is this weird observances. So I wonder if this is MJ Hoax, if Michael has anything to do with it. And you know, Michael could always tell somebody, "No, say it's you instead of me." I mean, that's, duh. Duh, sulfur gold from ashes. Oh, it's supposed to be Pablo Tarragamo. Tarragano. Watch the Alive docuseries, okay? I'm in on the game. So anyway, this is a part of that same video with Chamilla in it that we went over. Michael Jackson is Alive, Part 9, Weird Observances. And it was first uploaded April 21st, 2010. And then I showed you guys a screenshot of this date changing to January 15, 2012, which is the same day Peter Michael Bobby called me. All right. So here we go. Here is a forum that posted questions on how fans felt about MJ's death. Okay. I mentioned this. Rest in peace. Michael Jackson alive. Rest in peace. Okay. But get this. This forum was created May 2009. May 2009. Okay. All right. So here we go. These are the posts that are May 29th, which is Catherine and no, Latoya and Rebe's birthday. Catherine and Jackie are on the 3rd. Latoya and Rebe are May 29th, and Janet's May 16th, and I'm May 6th. All the ladies in Michael's life is May. Hey. Anyway, welcome to Michael Jackson Alive, right? May 29th, 2009, death announcement ain't happened. Michael Jackson is dead. What? May 29th, 2009. What do you like of the King of Pop, Michael Jackson? These are all May 29, 2009. I don't make this stuff happen. Okay, this is something that I had watched this video and I had reported on this. Okay, for the Chamilla. Okay, so you're probably wondering how I found this. Yeah, how'd you find it? Let's see. Let's listen some more. Because you, Michael, it was posted as a website on the following Twitter account. E. Casanova's Twitter account. E. Casanova Evans, he posted it. Bio, an actor. MichaelJacksonAlive.com. When you click on the website, it takes you to the page I just showed you, MichaelJacksonAlive.com. Remember I told you guys and I showed you all those domains that was registered on June 25th, 2009? Let's see if anything's here. There ain't nothing here because, you know, he didn't keep up with it. Michael, and then the estate after I owned first Michael Jackson death hoax was registered June 25th, 2009, right? And Michael Jackson hoax death too on death announcement day. Then I bought it and then Michael bought it and then the estate owns it. Okay, so I'm just saying. So there's nothing for MichaelJacksonAlive.com. There's nothing, okay? So, but there was something though. Okay, there's nothing. Okay, there's nothing there, okay? Because Michael's covering his tracks. You know how to set up so many clues. But see, I'm the historian, right? So as the historian, I've kept up with a whole bunch of information. And I had that in my suicide book because how could you watch that video about Chamilla and not go, oh my God, May 2009, Michael Jackson is dead. What? He hasn't died yet. It's the 29th, right? So anyway, and it might be Michael's way of saying, my mama and my family know. That's why I was on the 29th, you know, or my sisters know. You know, my sisters, because Catherine's promo code for her book, Never Can Say Goodbye, was MJ Lives. I don't watch my live docuseries and the Suicide movie book, okay? So anyway, so that's kind of fun. That's fun. So now we're going to go to Brandon. Before we do Brandon, we're going to do Elvis. We're going to do Elvis, okay? Now, one thing that anyone who knows Michael, he talks nonverbally. He uses Justin Bieber to leave clues, like the wink, nod, smile, and Macy's, and that's where he came and gave me the hug, and so you got to be on his mental level, and everybody isn't, and everybody don't have time for the games that Michael plays, and I just find it kind of fun, you know, and so I play. Okay, so here, this one here. Is Michael was trending January 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. I think Billie Jean was trending too, right? And we went over that. But why did Elvis start trending on the 3rd? Elvis 2023, that's 46 years later after the death announcement. There's nothing about 46. You know, I don't know. Elvis, I never found out why this was important, and I never found out why Michael was trending, because you could pay for things to be trending. You can pay. Okay, so I think that it was just kind of like a death hoax. I think Michael and Bronca are playing games with us because John Bronca had just mentioned, John Bronca had just mentioned Elvis too, right? So let's look at that. Let's take a look. Okay. Here we go.
Buys Cadillacs. Frank DeLeo, Michael's manager, told him that story. So when I was able to close the deal to buy him the Beatles catalog, Michael gave me my first Rolls Royce. I was 34 years old at the time. It was a beautiful convertible, a Corniche. Later on, when I bought Neverland for him, he actually gave me a second Rolls Royce at the age of 36. So at the age of 36, I was driving two Rolls Royces thanks to Michael. But I then acquired a taste for luxury cars. My whole life, I've been a Rolls Royce fan. And as you can see, I've got two today. You know, I have Michael to thank for that. And over the years, they've been featured in House and Garden magazine, in L'Uomo Vogue, also featured in Ferrari magazine, which indicated my love of cars. Plus with the women I've dated over the years, we always had fun taking car pictures. It's become a big part of my life. I have to admit, I'm more of a luxury car guy than a sports car guy. That's the genesis of my love for cars. Michael had heard that Elvis Presley used to give all of his guys Cadillacs. Frank DeLeo, Michael's manager, told him that story. So,
okay, so this was John Branca's last video. That was on the come on, why won't you come? I don't get it. I'm trying to just get to Branca's little page. Okay. Oh, there it is. Okay. So, yeah, so that was the last video that he did, and that was on the 5 days ago, so it was not the last day of the year. So, a few days later, so are they both trying to send some Elvis-Michael comparison stuff? Because play after play after play, like LMP said, Lisa Marie said, was identical to her father's, okay? So, and I think that's why Michael wanted to know, did Elvis really fake his death? So he got to know Lisa. I'm going to end up just like your dad, just like your father, you know? And he told that to Thomas Dolby. Hold on. Let's go to Thomas Dolby. Okay, let me see here. Okay, let's go here. So we're going to play this again, a little bit of it. Okay, again, this is my Alive 3.
Was not real, but she was nice enough to go along with the marriage hoax. Lisa Marie tells Oprah Winfrey that Michael often told her he was going to end up just like her dad.
Michael was always asking you about your father.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And he said, I feel like I'm going to end up the same way.
And did you say why?
Yeah. I was like, what are you talking about? And I don't understand. Down to the play-by-play-by-play incident.
Game, play.
Identical.
And singer Thomas Dolby writes in his book, The Speed of Sound Breaking the Barrier Between Music and Technology, that Michael told him, quote, I want to die just like Elvis. And that was way back in 1982.
All right, see?
Michael Jackson.
Okay, so I do a whole big old thing with Elvis and Michael in the comparisons, okay? Thomas Dolby. Sometimes I'm just talking. And I was talking to one of my friends and we were just talking. And then, boom, a clue. Boom, something comes to me, right? So, here we go. So, we did that. So, I'm going to have you guys listen to Thomas Dolby's biggest hit. Now, you people from the 80s. Now, this is fair use, Facebook. Fair use, because I'm doing this different than just listening to music, okay? This is educational. All right, so here, now we're going to listen to Thomas Dolby's Blinded Me with Science, right? You're like, where are you going with that, Pearl Jr.? Here we go. Okay, Blinded Me with Science. Here we go. Okay, so I know you guys are like, where is she going with Blinding Me with Science with Thomas Dolby? Okay, so we got that. Now, he's 82. I told you, 82, Thriller time, is when Michael and Thomas Dolby was hanging out. Okay, they was buddies, and Thomas Dolby went to Havenhurst because Michael was still living with his mama and daddy, okay, in Havenhurst. So mommy and daddy couldn't be too bad. Michael didn't leave that house till he's 28 years old. All right. So, Blinded Me with Science. Do you guys remember that? Well, there was a song that was produced and supposed to have been released on the Bad album, and it didn't make the Bad album. Okay. It's called Song Theory, and it's called Abortion Papers. I'm just singing. Okay. I'm gonna play you some of it. So, you can hear Blinding Me with Science, and you can hear that song with Abortion Papers, right? Right? So, Michael must have been, see, sometimes he'll write the song and write the lyrics and not record it for years, right? I believe that in the 80s, early 80s, when Mickey Howard, hey, I'm pregnant. Michael, no, it's not mine. Yeah, it is, Michael. It ain't. Yeah, it is, Michael. Because the lie becomes the truth. Okay. Eyes just like mine. Oh, no. She's not my lover. I did it. And then he was like, the lie becomes the truth. You know, God. Oh, gee whiz. Joe Jackson didn't believe in abortions. Under any circumstances, Joe Jackson was more of a Republican in that way than a Democrat. He was a Democrat in the way of, you know, no racism and no white supremacy, but he was a conservative because most people, when they get older, they're more conservative, okay? But he didn't believe in abortions. Remember the scene in the Jacksons' American Dream when Catherine accidentally got pregnant, messing around with Joe? Little green-eyed, blue-eyed Negro. They, you know, they mean something. They meant something back then. I'm telling you. Okay? And she gave it up. She gave up the cooch. Okay? And this was way back when. Okay? And she got pregnant. And Joe said, she said, no, Joe, I don't want to mess up your plans. You're going to be a boxer. I don't want to mess up your plans. I'm going to get an abortion. Joe was like, I don't want to hear that. Oh, no. Because Joe had been married. They met Catherine. Catherine was in love. He left, married another woman. It didn't work out. Came back to Katie. My middle name, Kate. Came back to Katie. Okay. And they did the thing. And she got pregnant out of wedlock. And then he did the right thing, because he don't believe in abortions. And he married her. And then the rest is history, right? Then all the children came. Right? All the children came. I have something else that I will show you guys, but I'll show you another time, okay? So, why is Michael thinking about abortion so much that he writing songs about the abortion? Writing songs about abortion, right? Abortion Papers, unreleased from Bad Album, 87, but recorded in 86. But he was hanging with Thomas Dolby in 82. Brandon was born 81. Okay, that's the story. Billie Jean was released just a few days ago, 40 years ago, on January 2nd. Okay, I'm just saying this is, and then can't feed the baby, don't have the baby. Billie Jean always talking when nobody else is talking. He had Billie Jean on his mind. Okay, and he had babies on his mind and kids on his mind. Okay, that song, Billie Jean, is autobiographical. Okay, that's his life. Okay, the lie becomes the truth because it's the truth. And Mickey must have signed an NDA. And they covered it up and had her marry Augie Johnson, who's on the Off the Wall album as a backup singer. Right? That was the beginning of them cleaning stuff up and media tricks and how do you know, keep your image. Michael was about to be the most popular bachelor on the planet Earth. Okay, everything he worked for. Then all of a sudden, guess what, baby? We having a baby. He panicked. But he couldn't panic that much. He did that Billie Jean song. Okay? And want to be starting something. And abortion papers. He's like, I can't abort the baby. I can't. Okay? Because he didn't believe in abortions because Joe didn't believe in abortions. Okay, so that is my new little clue about Thomas Dolby, Michael's head at that time. Okay, and we got the mixing of the two songs. They sound very, very, very much alike. Okay, so there it is. More proof that Brandon is Michael Jackson's biological son. It just all matches. If you don't know and you want to know some more, watch Alive 3. And if you want to know some more stuff, don't underestimate this. This will blow your mind. You'd be sitting there the whole time you're watching it. Okay? And then Alive 4, Michael Jackson, The Missing Pieces. And hopefully I'll be able to do Alive 5. So you guys, you know, if you bought some shea butter, if you know anybody who needs shea butter, or if you just want to donate, send my link out. send the www.stazaldayshay.com out so I can afford to do a live five. I really, really, really want to do a live five. Okay? And then I'm done. Okay? So that's it for today. And let me make sure there's no more. I don't think there's anything else that I need. Let me make sure that that's it. I think that's it, guys. And I will see you. I'm looking here to see if anybody asked me any questions. I will see you guys next time. Blinded me with science. Doo, doo, doo. And then Michael with abortion papers. I want to hear a little bit more.
With
oh man, got the right got, oh man, I went moved it and got a commercial. Where'd it go? See, they don't want me to hear it again. Oh, and Michael wrote the song Hyperactive for Michael, and he said it just they were going into a different direction, but it was a big hit of Thomas Dolby's as well.
To keep my mouth from spouting junk.
Michael said it wasn't gonna work because he wrote this Hyperactive for Michael Thomas Dolby did. Okay. This was the jam. We thank Thomas Dolby for that and let you hear the two comparisons. And so that's where Michael's head was at in the early 80s. That's where he was at. All right, guys. And another thing, if Brandon was just some kid that hung out at the house, how come we ain't got pictures of him? How come Brandon ain't supposed to be in no pictures? Because Michael was not trying to get that secret out, but he had his son right there. His son was in his family the whole time, okay? And I also wonder about Dante. I really, really do. I wonder about Dante because Dante just showed up and Alejandra took care of Dante and she lived at Havenhurst for free and Michael paid all the bills at Havenhurst. Why would Michael do that for her, for Jermaine and Randy's kids? Because she was taking care of Michael's kid. That's what I think. Makes sense to me, but do I know for sure? I don't know. I'm just putting stuff together. All right. So see you next time, guys. Love you. Bye bye. I'm going through. No more. No, there's no question. Okay. Bye, guys.